General heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. So we will be having three axes. This is x axis, y axis and z axis, in which we are considering a rectangular components of length dx, breadth dz and height dy. So first of all, we are taking this heat transfer in x direction. So this is the x direction. So the energy, heat energy entering is taken as Q, and heat energy going out is taken as Q plus dQ. So Q is equal to Ka dT by dx, that is the Fourier equation. Now what we have is, so energy is entering and a part of energy is going out. So energy in minus energy out will be the energy stored inside this element. So in x direction, energy in is Q, energy out is Q plus dQ. So in minus out, that is Q minus Q plus dQ. That is equal to minus dq. So minus dq we are multiplying and divided by dx. So we can write in this form. But q we know q is equal to ka dt by dx. So in place of q we are substituting this one, minus ka dt by dx. And this k and a are constant. So we are taking them out. So ka is taken out. D by dx of dt by dx is written as d square d by dx square. And this a is the area of cross section in x direction. So in x direction, area cross section is this one. So this is dz and this is dy. So a can be written as dy into dz. So it's a is substituted as dy dz. So we can write in x direction, the energy store is k into dx dy dz into d square t by dx square. So in y direction, simply we want to change this x into y. So this x is changed to y. So in y direction, stored heat is equal to k dx dy dz d square t by dy square. In z direction, this x is written as z. So in z direction, it is k dx dy dz d square t by dz square. So here, in total, we have the energy stored because of the heat transfer in three directions. Now suppose say that some heat is generated inside this volume. So let us say in unit volume, a heat Q is generated. But the total volume is dx into dy into dz. So in total volume, the heat generation will be equal to q into dx dy dz. So in net, the energy is stored because of heat transfer in various direction and also due to generation of heat. So the sum of all these four equations, we will get the net energy stored. And because of this energy storing, there will be a temperature change, and let us take that initially the temperature was T and after that the temperature is T plus dT. After the storage of energy it is T plus dT. So the net change in temperature is dT. Now for a given mass M and of specific heat capacity C, the energy stored will be MC dT. So it is given as MC dT. It is the energy, net energy stored. So mass is rho into volume. So rho into volume dx dy dz into c dt. So this is the net energy stored. But Fourier equation gives the energy transfer in 1 second. So these all are for energy transfer in 1 second. So here we should change this energy stored for per unit time. We have to change it to unit time. So mc dt by delta t, but that is by dt we will get the energy stored in unit time, that is rho dx dy dz in c dt. So this is the energy stored in unit time, and that will be equal to sum of all these four equations. So we are equating this one, this particular term, that is the fourth term, where dx dy dz is cancelled from every equation. So we will, in net we will get this equation. This is our general heat conduction equation. And in this, if there is no heat generation, we will cancel this Q. And if it is steady state, we will cancel this one, steady state equation. So this is how we write general heat conduction equation. Thank you.